Hey Earthlings, Happy New Year! As we step into the new year, a question some of us looking to get a new computer might face is, should I buy a desktop or should I go for a laptop? If you're watching this video, chances are that you've thought about this question at least once in your life. Don't worry, I've got you covered. With over a decade of experience as being a tech guy, I'm here to break it down for you. Whether you're looking to gaming, studying, or just chilling with some Netflix and YouTube, we figure out which one's the perfect fit for you. So let's dive in. Welcome to another YouTube video. Today, we are diving into key reasons why you should go for a desktop or a laptop when choosing a new computer. I will break it all down for you and you will get to decide what fits you perfectly. At the end of this video, I will reveal what I personally use and why, which might shock a lot of you. So stick around to the end to find out. Before I get started, don't forget to leave a like on the video and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Also, I want to know, are you team desktop or team laptop? Let me know in the comments below. And whichever team gets the most votes wins. So let's see where you all actually stand. So to begin, let me explain what a laptop is. A laptop is a portable computer designed to be used in multiple locations. And examples include MacBooks or Windows laptops that students carry around to school every day. On the other hand, a desktop is a computer designed for stationary use. Think of Dell towers that you see in old offices or computer cafes. Now that you've got the basics, let's dive into the key reasons why you should either go for a desktop or just go for a laptop. So let's start with form factor, which is the biggest difference between a desktop and a laptop, and also should be your most important consideration. As their definition suggests, if you're looking for a computer you can move from place to place, a laptop is the obvious choice as it is designed specifically for that. But if you're okay having your computer in the same spot, like in an office or a room, then a desktop might be the way to go. Now I can hear some of you saying, but mini ITX, shut up. Sure. Mini ITX desktops are compact and technically movable, but are you really going to carry one to the class or a cafe? Don't forget you would also need a mouse, a keyboard and a screen to use a mini ITX. So yeah, vamos please. If you really don't care about form factor, then this next point might just be the most important deciding factor for you. Performance. This for most people is another huge deciding factor. So I'm going to break it down into three. The high tier, the mid tier, and the low tier. High tier. This is for those people looking for top tier performance for demanding tasks like video editing, gaming, or 3D renders. The mid tier. This is for people who perform moderately intensive tasks. They don't really need the best of the best to get work done. Just something that can carry their tasks smoothly and without lag. Then we have the low tier. This is for those people who perform very basic tasks with computers. Stuff like watching Netflix, sending mails, or writing PDFs. Now, if you fall into the high tier, listen closely. A desktop can outperform a similarly specced laptop by up to 40% in some cases. And this is because desktops are physically larger, allowing for things like bigger fans, better cooling systems, and full-sized components which are shrunken down to fit most laptops. For example, here is a picture comparing a desktop RTX 1490 GPU alone to a laptop. Quite drastic, right? However, that does not mean laptops cannot deliver high-tier performance. In fact, some high-end laptops equipped with the RTX 4090 can deliver performance close to that of the RTX 4080 on a desktop PC, which to me is quite impressive. However, if maximum achievable performance is what you're running after, then desktops are the clear winner. But before you decide, let's talk about the next point, which is efficiency. Laptops being physically smaller are limited in total power draw due to cooling constraints. And remember, the bigger the part, the more power draw it needs and the more cooling is required. And this alone makes laptops inherently more efficient than desktop. Some laptops use about half the total power draw that a similarly specced desktop counterpart would use, all while still delivering comparable performance. This efficiency unlocks up to 20 hours of battery backup time on a laptop. This is a game changer if you find yourself in a situation where there's frequent power outage or if you're just on the go. This efficiency can also save you a significant amount on your total electricity bill. A perfect choice if you value efficiency and mobility. Now let's talk about something that could either save you some money or cost you big in the long term: upgradability and repairability. So for this, I want you to think of laptops as the Teslas of computers. They're sleek and modern, but highly limited when it comes to user repairability and upgradability. If something ever goes wrong in it, you'll likely have to hand it over to a professional or the company itself to fix it for you. And even the upgrades that are granted to you are extremely limited, things like RAM. I know some companies even solder the RAM on board, which makes it totally non-viable to replace or upgrade down the line. Apple, I'm looking at you. Apple, yeah? I'm looking at you guys. Desktops, on the other hand, are like Toyotas. Reliable, modular, and usually built to last. If something ever fails, you can easily order for a replacement part and swap it out by yourself. This modularity doesn't make upgrades and repairs just simpler, but also prevents you from throwing away an entire computer if a part goes bad, unlike in most laptops. Now, which should you choose? After going through the differences with you guys, and this is still your question, I would recommend you watch the entire video to gain some clarity. Also, you might be asking the wrong question. The right choice depends on what you need it for, how much space you have, and your long-term plans with it. For example, people are usually shocked when I tell them that I do not own a desktop. All of my setup is run from just one single laptop. As a YouTuber who works a lot on the go, travels frequently and loves to game, a desktop just doesn't fit my lifestyle. And that is why I went with a Lenovo Legion Pro 7, which has an i9 13th gen and an RTX 4080 GPU, which is more than capable for everything I do. Here is a video of me playing games in Rwanda with the same laptop. And I've also done this in many other countries and places, which I bet you can't do with your desktop. Also, always respect people's choices, as their current setup represents their situation, their needs, and their preferences. And for a topic like this, there really isn't anyone right or wrong. Just pick whatever works for you. And if you're still clowning people for their choices, guess what? The real clown is staring at you when you turn off the display of your phone. Also, let me know, what team are you? Leave that in the comments below. As for me, I am proudly Team Laptop, but I might be switching soon, so stay tuned. Don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on your post notifications. Bye, Earthlings. I will break it all down for you. Who's there? Good evening. I'm busy currently. Quite drastic, right?